today and a little bit on Tuesday, we're going to be talking about what an inverse function is. We will also start on exponentials on Tuesday next week. But there's a video, let's see, where is it? Right here, Understanding Inverses and Negative Symbols, that is very helpful to understand how we use the negative symbol in mathematics. I will probably be talking about it today during lecture, but I wanted to point that out because that's an important thing for especially students at home that should take a look at that and think about it carefully. Okay. And the other thing I want to say about inverses is it's very important that you understand what the inverse of a function is before we get to logarithms. Because we're going to start talking about exponential functions next week. They're not too bad. Most people are fine with the exponential functions. But then we go to the inverse of those, which are logarithms. And so that's really, really important that you know this section first and understand it thoroughly before we get there. Okay, so first of all, we're going to review what a function is. Relations are just sets of points. So I'm just giving you this arbitrary set of points here. This is called a finite relation because there's only one, two, three members in the relation. And what it's showing, remember, is pairing. So 1 is paired with 3, 0 is paired with 4, negative 2 is paired with 7. Now remember that a function is one where all the first members, we call those the elements of the domain, are paired with just one thing in the range, right? Do y'all remember that about functions? Okay, so is that first one a function? Is that first relation a function? What do you say? Yes, because every x is paired with exactly one y. So that one is a function. Okay, what about the second example? See something that's paired with two things?
Because the 0 is paired with the 4 and with the 5.
Right. 0 is paired with two different things, so although that is what we call a relation, it's not the special kind of relation, which is a function. Okay? Now, from unit 2, do you know what the picture of this would look like if we drew it? Y equals x squared minus 4x plus 3. What's that a picture of?
A parabola.
Yes, good. That's a parabola. It's an upward opening parabola, right? And so will that be a is that a function? Is every x paired with one y? Yes, this is a function as well. It passes what kind of test?
Vertical line.
Right, vertical line test. Okay, now the next one is actually from unit 1. Does anybody recognize what that figure looks like? Most of you didn't like them very much. Anybody notice? It's a circle. Remember those? Is that coming back? It's not coming back. No, how terrible. We've had a memory dump. Okay, just get rid of that memory. That terrible circle memory. Okay, well, it is a circle. It is centered. It's actually something called the unit circle, which people taking trig should know about. But it's centered at 0, 0. It's got a radius of 1. Remember, this is the radius squared, but the square root of 1 is still 1. And so it is a set of points that represents a circle. And is a circle going to be a function?
No.
No, it's not a function. It doesn't pass the vertical line test. Anybody recognize the last thing? Yeah, that's a line. That's a line, and it's not a vertical line. Vertical lines are not functions. It crosses at negative 4. It has a slope of 2. I'm not going to worry about drawing it too much right now, but I just know it leans to the right because it's a positive slope. And so is that a function?
Yes,
that one is a function. Okay, so what we were looking at there is that out of all these groups of points, 1... 3 and 5 are functions. Okay? So, is everybody good remembering what a function is? So let's define it. I want you to think about that for a minute. answers that don't really quite get to the point of what a function is. So a function is a relation, so a set of points or a pairing, some pairings, in which every input value is what? Paired. This word is important. With what? How many outputs?
One
output. Let's just emphasize exactly one output value. So the direction of the pairing matters, and it's that the input values can only be paired with one output. What's that?
The y's can be the same.
Yes, the y's can be the same. Okay, now, we're going to talk about what an inverse is then. So before we do this, and that's what that video will go into more depth on, if you take a look at that. We use the inverse, the negative symbol to mean inverse. I'll talk about that a little bit more when we get into inverse functions. But inverse is doing the opposite thing, right? You know, what's the inverse of adding?
Subtracting.
What's the inverse of multiplying?
Dividing.
Those are operations, and you guys know what their inverses are. What is a function? It's a pairing in a certain direction. Focus on that. It's pairing an input with an output. So what would the inverse of that be? Pair the other direction. Yes. Pair in the opposite direction. So the inverse of a relation is pair in the opposite direction. Those same sets, or those same points. So in other words, let's say you have relation R and it contains the point 1, 3. Okay? The inverse of R would contain the point 3, 1. Yes. Those pairings just get turned around. All right? It's not a hard concept. It's just that people get so used to it. This is why when we were talking about functions in the beginning of the semester, I said, let's get away from saying plugging in, okay, and talk about pairing. Okay, so what are the inverses of each of the functions from slide one? And I'm only looking at the functions. Okay, the inverse of the one that's just the set of three points is 3, 1. 0 and 7, negative 2. Just turn the pairing around. Okay? Now, the second function, the thing that you said was a parabola, there's an infinite set of points, right? I mean, we could draw a picture of what it looks like. So we could certainly find some points and turn them around to kind of get an idea of what it looks like. But what do you think I would do when what I've got is a rule? How do I find the inverse? What is it? Well, that's one point, right? So certainly if 0, 3 is a point in this relation, then 3, 0 is a point in the inverse. That's true.
We just divide by negative?
Well, that is assuming that what's opposite here, or the inverse, is division or just subtraction instead.
Find the zeros? Yeah.
Okay, now you guys are talking about finding some other points, and you would certainly be able to do that. And let's do that real quick. Suggestion was to find the x-intercept. So this is the y-intercept. And we can see that the x-intercepts are 3, 0, and 1, 0. So that means I know three points on the inverse, right? Anybody have any other idea? Yeah.
The parallel of that.
The what?
The parallel line of that.
Parallel line? Are you thinking about the axis of symmetry, maybe?
Maybe.
Maybe? Okay. Let me just get some. All right. You could investigate this, right? You could plot these points and then plot their inverses, and you could kind of see the inverse sort of coming out of that. In fact, we can do that. But this is what I was hoping somebody would think about. You got to swap X and Y, right? Okay, you just got to swap X and Y. All right. So let's actually, we know 3 points that are in this thing, so let's plot them. I should probably find the vertex, too. Has anybody found the vertex by chance? The vertex is 2, it's halfway between these, 2 and then 4 minus 8. The 2, negative 1, somebody please check me on that. What's that? Yeah, do calculate it for me because I did it in my head, so. It is correct, 2, -1. Okay. All right, now what I'm doing, I'm just going to plot these points, so I'm turning all those points that you guys were mentioning around. Because if those 4 points are on y equals x squared minus 4x plus 3, then turn those points around. Those should all be on this graph, right? So let's plot those. 3, 0, 0, 3, 0, 1, and negative 1, 2. You can kind of see what's happening here. You get a sideways parabola. And if you'll plug these numbers in, you'll see that those work. Like if I plug in 3 for, 0 for y, then I'm going to get 3 for x, for example.
Yeah.
So if you plug in those x's and y's, you'll see that they all work. But the point is, if you have this relation, then the way you get its inverse is you swap x and y. Now, is this easy to solve for y? It's not very easy to solve for y. Is it a function? Is the inverse a function? It is not a function. That's right. Because what happened was, remember with parabolas, you've got two x's. You've got two x's that are paired with the same y, right? So that's getting turned around. So that there's two different y's that are paired with the same x. Okay. All right. So now that you know that, can you tell me what the inverse of y equals 2x minus 4 is? What's the inverse of that? Do the same thing.
X equals
2y
minus
4. Yeah. X equals 2y minus 4 is the inverse of y equals 2x minus 4. Let's solve that one. You can solve easily for y. So let's solve it for y, and then you're going to tell me whether you think it's a function or not. So I'm going to add 4 and do what?
Divide.
Yeah, divide by 2. And so we get that y is x plus 4 divided by 2. Now that's actually a line also. You could separate these two and get 1/2 x plus 2. So it's a line that goes through 2 on the y-axis, and it's got a slope of 1/2. So it's a line as well. So what do you think? You think this is a function? It is a function. If you're going to draw that line, it's just not a very steep line. But it's definitely going to be a function, right? Okay. So, let's see what happened. With the first one, did we get a function when we had the inverse? Okay. This is also a function. saw with the parabola, what happened was we didn't get a function. So the inverse was not a function. It's a set of points, but it's just not a function. And then with the line, and let's do a little rough sketch of this line. Here's negative 4, and then it's got a slope of 2. Okay? Its inverse was also a line, and that was a function as well. So, there's something called a one-to-one function, which is what this first example and then the line are. The parabola was not one-to-one. And I'm showing you the test for one-to-one. What's the test for a function? Vertical line. What's the test to see if the function is also what's called one-to-one? Horizontal line. So what does one-to-one mean? It means every x is paired with one y, and every y only had one x paired with it. Okay? Why is that important? So I put your definition of a one-to-one function here. Why is that important? Well, the inverse of a one-to-one function is also a function. So what we're going to do with these next things, some of them are recognizable, and some of them you may not be sure what they look like. So we'll go to the graphing calculator on this first one, and you're just going to tell me whether it's one-to-one or not. Okay? Minus 3x power 2 minus 2x plus 4. Okay, and I'm going to do zoom 6. I think we'll be able to see what's going on with this one. Yeah, there you go. So is that a one-to-one function? What do y'all say?
Yeah.
Okay, function passes the vertical line test. One-to-one,
no, it doesn't.
It does not. It does not pass the vertical, the horizontal line test. And so that one is not one-to-one. So that's going to mean that there's not a, its inverse is not a function. So same that one, that one. Okay, now a little mini review on this one. That's that absolute value function that you learned in the first unit. Remember what the shape is? It's that V shape. You know, you've got opposite X's that, because you're taking the absolute value, it's kind of like a parabola in a way, except that it's linear on each side. Right? 2 and negative 2, don't they produce the same value? Okay, so is it 1 to 1? Guys, is it past the horizontal line?
No, it isn't.
No. Okay, so that one's not. Now the last one is the square root function, so I want you to remember that one as well. You could use your calculator, but remember that y equals square root of x looks like that. And so if we add 2 to the x, do y'all remember what happens? A little mini review here.
Does it go up 2 or does it go sideways 2?
The up 2 is if it's on the outside.
Oh, okay.
It shifts left 2. Yes, it shifts to the left 2. So it's going to start back here. See, negative 2 plus 2, that's square root of 0. So it starts here. It looks like that. Now, that just keeps going outward, right? Upward and outward as you go on. And so would it pass the horizontal line test? Mm-hmm. Would you say, yes, that one does. So that is a one-to-one function.
Do you have to
find the inverse of the like
no, 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 okay. You, the question was, do you have to find inverses for ones like this? No, you do not. Good news there. All right, so I want to start with you guys fresh on Tuesday. So what I would like you to do between now, you have to do your polynomial functions homework. What I would like you to do between now and Tuesday is review what we've talked about so far so we can come back to this idea and we're going to find inverses for one-to-one functions on Tuesday. But we'll do it when you're nice and fresh because I can tell that we're getting a little tired today and I built in a little extra homework. Okay? So we'll stop. We'll have two parts.